Those frustrations of walking in and not knowing where to start, but hopefully having your comrades and colleagues around is, I think, one of the reasons that we don't stand as independents. Yeah. One of the differences, that we're not just individuals floating around in the council or in our communities, but we are here as a party, both in the council and in our communities, to support each other, to make sure that we work together and with each other to achieve the aims and the goals that we need. And particularly in Brighton and metropolitan areas across the country, where you have numerous councillors per ward, that team approach is even more important, because you, when you are elected a councillor here in the city, which is slightly different from, say, in parts of rural East Sussex or West Sussex, you will be there with other Labour councillors. And so it means you are never alone. And you must never feel alone, because that is the importance of socialism. Not only are we there for our communities, we are there for our comrades here. And I think that things have improved in terms of training and support, and that's hopefully what this will encourage you to do tonight. I remember when I was a councillor, a very particular difficulty in trying to get someone to be moved from emergency accommodation to temporary accommodation, slightly more permanent accommodation. Emergency really means temporary, they're temporary in there. Temporary means you could be in there for up to 10 years. So, you know, kind of, these are the kind of weird terms that we use. And this person was scared, yes, about moving, about the disruption to his life. And us as a group of councillors sat down with him, helped him, and I hope mentored him to make the right choices. And we did that not only as a team, but also knowing that we couldn't change the rules, but very often what is needed is a constituent and a resident to hear that there is someone that's listening, someone that is there for them. Because in a world of austerity and in a world of neoliberalism, what happens is you break those social connections one by one. You break up the idea that you know people in your workplace. You break up the idea that you know people in communities. So you have none of those resilience networks that you can share and you can talk to. And of course, that is why becoming a Labour councillor is even so more important. Because what you are in an age of austerity is you are both the front line and often the last line of the state and of the city. And so many people need that at the moment. And it is difficult. And even when you have a majority council, it is difficult.